Welcome back. You're watching Wisconsin Women. Today we've been meeting with our guests here at Evolution Body Transformation. Later in the program, we'll be talking with them about the difference between medical grade supplements and those that you can get over the counter. Is there a difference or not? We'll find out a little bit later. Right now though, we're talking with Madison Magazine. Now for over 40 years, they've been producing award-winning journalism and putting out articles about where to go, what to do, and what's happening in and around the Madison area. Joining us is editor Andrea Bailing. Nice to see
you again. Nice to see you guys. Thanks for having me.
It's been a while since I've seen you, Andrea. Yeah. It's so fun to chat with you always about what's going on in the magazine. You guys do really, really an amazing job.
Thank you.
Now, on the cover, I love this topic because true Wisconsin is supper clubs. And that's your cover story. Tell us a little bit about it.
Definitely true Wisconsin. I think people just love supper clubs. And we set out to kind of see how the supper club has evolved over time, because it's a beloved 100-year tradition here in Wisconsin, even longer in the United States. So we kind of did a case study of a new open that's inspired by a supper club, the Harvey House, that's featured on our cover. We also looked at a supper club that's been around for a long time, the Dell Bar in the Wisconsin Dells.
Yes.
And then also two new opens that are yet to open, the Cranberry Club and Driftless Social in Mount Horeb. So kind of take a look at what they're doing, how they're preserving the traditions, but also kind of putting their own modern spin on the dining experience.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. And I love how you separated out from, like, you know, in different areas of the Madison area.
Totally. Yeah. Yep. They're well, and that's kind of it's a destination restaurant. A lot of people go way up north for a supper club experience, but there's a lot here in Madison too.
Yeah. And you guys always have the best food section. Besides even the cover story section, you guys always have another section, the food section, that, and this time it's with food and wine. Right?
Yes, wineries. Okay. I feel like we're kind of tiptoeing into outdoor winery season.
Yes.
So we put together a guide that lists a bunch of wineries for your next winery road trip. That's also a fun, just get in your car and hit up a couple of them. It'd be a fun day.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Nice. Yeah, I did that a couple weeks ago for my niece's birthday. We went to Bailey's.
Oh, Bailey's Farm.
Yes,
nice.
Yes, so yes. Nice. Yeah.
So cute.
I love that place.
Yep.
Yeah.
Andrea, I'm also intrigued by an article in there about a DNA hunter. What is that? And what's the article about?
Yeah. So one of our reporters found this woman there's so many people out there that, do ancestry.com to try to find their roots or find where they come from. But sometimes they get caught up in the process, or they hit a wall with their research. That's where this DNA hunter comes in. Mary Eberly is a woman in town here that kind of helps people kind of put the puzzle pieces together to find, find family, find their story, and really helps them go that extra step to kind of connect the genealogy dots.
How fun.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Oh my gosh. And you guys always feature interesting people. You always have a feature story on someone.
Yes.
And this one's kind of cool too, right?
It is. Yeah. Dexter Patterson. He actually co-founded a birding club for people of color, but so awesome. He's taken up this hobby and has totally kind of fallen into this passion of bird watching and sharing a bunch of bird photos. So we spotlight him, and then there's this awesome picture of him, and it compiles a couple of images of birds that he's taken photos of. So it's kind of cool.
Oh gosh.
A little something for everyone.
Yes.
Another part of your magazine is first person essays, and I'm wondering what the April issue is.
Yeah, this has been a fun addition. We've done these first-person essays for a year or so. This one's Michael Muckian, who usually writes A&E stories for us. He actually has this story. He used to be a Madison cab driver in the 1970s and realized that he had a very famous passenger in the back of his cab.
You're going to tell us who?
I feel like you got to read the story to find out, but very famous. Yeah, and then he got tickets to his concert a couple nights later, so he kind of tells the story of how he finds out who it is.
Yeah, can you imagine driving and then coming to the realization of, I wonder if that's so-and-so in my backseat.
Yeah.
Oh,
yep.
My gosh.
He kind of just asked him, are you? And he was like, I am.
Isn't that interesting? That reminds me of one time walking down State Street and I ran into Lyle Lovett.
Oh, did you really?
Ran into Lyle Lovett.
Yeah. And then I walked by and then I just said, excuse me.
Oh my goodness.
He's like, yes. I go, yeah. A nice little conversation with them.
Oh,
yeah, it's always fun.
Your
brush with fame.
Yeah. So, Andrea, always a great job in that magazine. How do people get a copy?
Yeah. The best way is to subscribe. You'll get it in your mailbox even before it hits newsstands. That's on our website, madisonmagazine.com.
Sounds great. Thanks so much, Andrea.
Thank you, guys. Thanks for having me.
Mm-hmm. And thank you for watching. We have more after the break.